So focusing on details first is a really common problem in design and in development, because when you do this, you can really only optimize locally. So what's a good solution for this problem? Well, in design, we have a technique. It's called wireframing, or low-res wireframing. It helps us really focus on the UX first and the big picture without getting caught in the UI details too soon. I know in development, they do something very similar.
Yeah, no, in development, there's a really easy trap to fall into is when you start coding, you just want to create functions. And you don't want to think about abstraction, you don't want to think about encapsulation. So as a Java developer, maybe you make the static class and you have a lot of methods in it and you forget about interfaces and classes altogether. That's again an example of in development where when you focus on the details, kind of bad things happen.
So it's kind of always a good idea in development and design to think about the big picture first. So the sign-in and the checkout example we just gave you, imagine that is part of an experience of a cookie buying application. So here's how you really get started. Imagine there's a task that your user wants to complete. So for this example, it's I'm hungry for cookies, I want to get some and eat the cookies, basically. So then you think about what steps does your user need to go through to complete this task. So this is an easy example because we only have one task. So the steps would be sign in, decide which cookies you want, pay for your cookies, and then eat the cookies. So when we write out each of these steps at a high level like this, each of these steps is kind of like a Java interface.
Exactly. When you think about a Java interface, it's something that doesn't have any implementation, so you're not really thinking about the low-level details, but you're thinking about the contract that interface has with other interfaces and classes, which in this case, if you look at the steps, it's how do these steps connect with each other.
Yep.
So instead of focusing on just one step and nothing else, you're really thinking about the big picture.
Exactly. So now that we're thinking about the sign-in experience as part of our overall flow in order to buy cookies, how do you think we should start?
Do we even need a sign-in experience?
You know, actually, we might not even need a sign-in experience. We could have an anonymous experience, because what if I just want to install the app and just get cookies? And maybe after I've used the application or even gotten some cookies for the first time, I might think, okay, maybe I'll use this application again.
That's a good point. But actually, the way I would use this application is that I actually do want to sign in because I want to see my order history and my payment history. And actually, I want to place orders that I've already placed before. So for me, like for someone like me, if I was a user, I would actually want the sign-in experience sooner rather than later.
So we could actually give the user an option of just getting straight into the app and buying cookies and skipping sign-in.
Right.
Or for users that are more like you, we could let them sign in initially.
Yeah, that's true. So actually what we could do is instead of having the sign-in happen up front, maybe we can actually allow them to flow through this application without signing in, but when they actually need to, then block them with the sign-in.
Just before checkout.
Yep. I like that. That would actually end up in a much nicer flow.
Yeah.
This is great. I hadn't even thought about it, but now that if we actually move the sign-in to this step, it actually ends up in a much better application.
I agree. I think that using low-res wireframing really helped us elevate the whole discussion. We could look at the sign-in experience and really see how it made the most sense to put in the application overall.
Exactly, which again, it results in a much better application for the end user.
Yep.
So we haven't really changed anything. We've just thought about it at a high level and optimized how they link up just like good interfaces should. And we can worry about the implementations later. I think this deserves a fist bump.
Low-res wireframing for the win.
Boom.